Now it's best to that.
All right, welcome back, everybody. We are now prepared for our time certain item. This is Commissioner Warren's item. Consider a proclamation recognizing that we are in a state of climate emergency. Commissioner Warren.
Yeah, thank you. I got a short statement here that I prepared, and I see that there are some members of the community that have helped me come to this point of appreciating the value of making such a statement and a proclamation. Many of you know that before I got involved with the city, I was really involved with environmental stuff. Then I get involved with the city and the issue of social justice, housing, education. All these other issues kind of took a forefront in the way I spent my time. But recently, the Florida Audubon Society had their Florida Assembly here just about a month ago. And as I was back with that group of people, I was just like, a family reunion, people I hadn't seen in a long time, and I'm like, I gotta find a way to bring the environmental conversation back into my life. And then shortly after that, I had a meeting here in the office with an individual who brought to me this document that I shared with you all. Oh, I didn't share with you, I had the clerks share with you on the proper way so that you would have that as a backup for this agenda today. And talking about making a statement that we realize we are in a position globally to recognize the impact our future actions can have on the planet. We don't need to piddle about, you know, how did we get here and who's to blame for any of that, but to be able to make a proclamation that we recognize that the condition of this planet is showing evidence of critical importance for the stability for my life and the future generations that will follow all of us. And this is not to reduce any of the work that we're doing for housing, social justice, racial equity. But if we don't do this, many of those other things are going to be harder to achieve. And there is a general conversation recognizing that in the next 10 years, the type of action that we take now and today will really have an impact in perpetuity. You know, there's so the request that I have is to be able to make a statement that we are in a climate emergency. And that's not to create chaos or you know, to put us in a state of panic, but similarly to how we deal when we get a statement and the weatherman tells us there's a hurricane coming. There's a way to be prepared. And there's a way to act and move forward in a way that is different than what I have found myself doing when I hear conversations about climate change and what one country is doing and what another is country doing and or what they aren't doing. You know, I've kind of just had it in the back of my head that somebody else is going to have to take care of this because it's a policy issue. And between 2000 and 2010, with my Audubon connections, I was able to go to DC on three occasions with the agenda of meeting with my representatives and to ask them to participate with some of the bills that were going through Congress or the Senate. And it was a disappointing return to my community because I didn't have support with our state representatives that were in DC. So I feel that now I could say, what would Greta do? I want to be a part of, you know, my generation has done a lot already to try to make changes, but it's not enough. And we as civic leaders in this community will always find that we have an opportunity to do the right thing while we are here, but to pass that baton on to the next generation. And I want to make sure that the next generation sees that we have done as much as we can to give them the setting that they will continue to work with. So the idea of this proclamation is to join voices with more than 11,000 other communities across the globe who have made such a proclamation that we are in an emergency position and that we need to recognize what we do on a regular basis that impacts our environment. And that this proclamation is to carry that message to Tallahassee and to Washington, D.C., to let them know that here in Gainesville, we want to do more than just be renewable energy, but that there are other things that we can look at regarding the impact that we have on climate change. There are many examples of proclamations which have been made in other cities, and I'll be able to share some of those. There's one of the members here of the audience here that had shared them with me, and I lent them to somebody and didn't get them back. But there are a lot of examples that our city could look at for examples on how to make a proper proclamation for climate emergency. So my ask here today is twofold. One is that we agree that we're willing to take a statement and a proclamation of climate emergency. And then the second ask that I would include would be for us to look at our staff, have our staff look at ways that we can address this issue with our comp plans and our policies, similar to what we've seen across the street with the county, to really bump up this conversation. And for an example, just the other day when we were doing our solar discussion and we were focusing on what we can do to have renewable energy by 2045. And when we've had that discussion, there's often been the comment, can we bring it up faster than that too? But Commissioner Ward, I commend you on making the comment to say, what about our carbon footprint? We can do this to go for renewable energy, but there are also things that we are doing now that impact that carbon footprint. And that can be improved upon with a proclamation and the policies that we can look at afterwards. Just this morning, as I was coming into City Hall, out on the plaza, there's a guy using a two-cycle edger to trim the bushes. Those are things that we can change easily within our city government to go to battery-operated maintenance equipment. There are several companies in town that do lawn maintenance with solar-powered panels on their roof. So what I'd like to do is to make a motion and see if I've got at least one person to second it, that we ask the city to develop a proclamation in support of a climate emergency.
Motion and a second. Thank you very much, commissioners. Commissioner Ward.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Commissioner Warren. I'm fully in support of this. I would ask that as a concrete step, and I'd be happy to move this otherwise, or if you'd be amenable, I would like us to direct the GRE general manager and the city manager to develop a dashboard that indicates our carbon footprint and
whoa,
a needle that shows which way we're going with it. We are at, and put that on the city's website. Because we direct a utility here, we can have an enormous impact on carbon emissions in North Florida. Many cities can have some impact by changing their fleet, by doing lots of very specific things. We can do those things, but we also are having an enormous carbon footprint because we own an electric utility. So I want us to be able to say to the people of Gainesville and the people of the world, this is what Gainesville is doing.
Yep.
You know, this is, you know, these are the hard numbers of where we are and which direction we are going as a city. Not what we say we're going to do, which is important, but what we can actually prove we are doing and hold ourselves accountable in that fashion. So if you would be amenable to making that part of your motion,
I would do gladly.
Great. And thank you again for that. And certainly I'm supportive. And I want to say, too, I want to reiterate what you said. This is not an either or thing. We have a climate emergency, I believe. We also have other things that we're dealing with that are extremely important. Equity and the environment are not separate issues. They are all together. When the environment crashes, we know who's going to be affected first, and
exactly,
it's not going to be the wealthiest part of our population. So I always bristle when people say, try to make it an either or. It is not. We are in this together, whether we like it or not. So I hope that we move forward in that spirit. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Hayes-Santos.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would ask if we could, well, I think we should do a proclamation. I also think a resolution might be good because that actually has a little more teeth in it and actually has things that we're planning on doing, kind of thing. So if we could add that motion to do both, I think would be good.
I'd be glad to have that considered with the motion, and certainly for the city to be able to look at its policies, coming up with a resolution would be a certain way to put that in the books.
Okay, we have a motion to work with staff to create a proclamation and a resolution declaring climate emergency, and to look how to integrate those with our comprehensive plan and other city policies, with a specific focus on racial disparity and equity, and also to create a dashboard showing our carbon footprint and the sort of, I guess, real-time adjustment to that. Members of the public that would like to speak to the motion, come on down. Just tell us who you are for the record. You'll have 3 minutes. When 1 minute's left, you'll have...
Thank you, Mayor Poole and Commissioners. My name is Jay Rosenbeck. I come before you today on behalf of the 535 members of the League of Women Voters of Alachua County to speak in support of this proposed proclamation. League members like you and other members of this audience are not naive. We realize that when there's a proposal that would have us do something different from business as usual, there's likely to be a great hue and cry, and especially questions are asked about how much is this going to cost me. Those kinds of economic discussions are absolutely critical, especially when held among people who understand economics. The economist Nicholas Stern has written a book-length discussion of the greater cost of doing nothing when compared to the cost of doing something. And business is on board too. If you have read the most recent report in 2019 from Goldman Sachs, you realize that business knows there are opportunities. In addition, I don't think it's necessary that we always talk about money when we talk about these kinds of issues. I would propose that there are some actions that have no or very little cost at all. Such a declaration can influence funding priorities, with priority given to projects having the greatest influence on our city's resilience. It can be a signboard. Projects can be announced with a sign that says Climate Resilience Project. It can be part of an environmental and social justice framework that supports actions by churches, by other institutions and organizations, and by individuals. It can legitimize the urgency to abandon business as usual that many citizens already feel. It can provide citizens with reasons for hope. It can confirm that politicians are as worried about their children and their children's children as they are. It can confirm the city's willingness to fill a leadership void on climate created by state and national timidity. And of course, we cannot preserve our grandchildren's world for free, but we can make a darn good start, and this is part of that start. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next speaker, please.
Mr. Mayor, fellow commissioners, I'm Jeffrey Shapiro, also a member of the League. The future is in play, as the proclamation will state. As Dr. Rosenbeck has said, the League of Women Voters of Alachua County stands behind the proposed proclamation. Last month, Nikki Freed, the Florida Commissioner of Agriculture, attended the Florida Energy and Climate Summit, the first since 2008. Her comments from the WUSF news report read, "The message from this summit was loud and clear. We need action now, and we need to be taking it together. And it needs to be collaborative. We cannot do this alone. We need partners up and down, from our local leaders to our state leaders to our national leaders." She also proposed creating a clean energy research center at one of Florida's state universities, with funding estimated at $20 million over 5 years. I believe that GRU and the City Commission will continue to think seriously about the implications of our changing climate and evolving technologies. I hope that you will be alert to actions that will enable both adaptation to and amelioration of future climate trends. GRU seems to be thinking mostly about the present and near future, which must include natural gas. However, it may be in the not-so-distant future that inevitably increasing natural gas prices and improving storage technologies and costs will make solar power viable as a primary energy source. Meanwhile, electric vehicles are here to stay. I bought a Prius Prime this year and rarely use any gasoline to power it when in town. In contrast to the state of Florida, New York State is already adapting to the penetration of electric vehicles. They predict an electric vehicle boom in the next 5 to 6 years based on the current numbers of statewide charging stations. And Gainesville is already adapting EVs for city use. At the same time, we recognize the fragility of our very significant proportion of economically challenged people. For example, the League of Women Voters is advocating much more affordable housing. As the climate continues to change, our city must adapt to our changing population structure and geographically based inequalities. We must develop in advance strategies to alleviate pressures on all of our populace from dynamic weather patterns and emergencies. It is up to our city voters and their elected officials to lead. The League of Women Voters supports our local democracy and independence from state authority through home rule. We believe that North Central Florida will best be able to handle its own adaptation to the climate emergency now taking force. That is why the League supports a proclamation of climate emergency. Thank you.
Thank you. Next speaker, please.
Ms. Mayor, Jim Connish. While this city spent hundreds of millions of dollars on a wood-burning power plant, can I have the overhead, please? On a wood-burning power plant that provides base load we don't need, you have neglected small details like your outdoor lighting, which is predominantly inefficient non-LED lights that you have the audacity to overcharge people for, including the school board and the county. And when you roll this ordinance back tonight, you refuse to answer my very simple question. Are you going to give us the overcharge back voluntarily, or are we going to extract it from you? But you need to answer this question. Don't force me to come back here. I'd like to have the evening off. But this kind of misplaced priorities, where you try to sweep your failures like this under the rug of some nebulous, spaced out slogan, I just don't see how the most educated community, the youngest community, the most progressive community in the state of Florida can buy this charade. You are far and away the largest polluter. You burn trees, you burn coal full of mercury, you spill your sewage all over the place with complete impunity around the clock through your decrepit clay sewer mains. And you have the audacity to pontificate upon the state of the global climate when you destroy a relatively pristine place that has been my home since 1972. And I'm impacted by your activities in the northwest corner of the county where I own land. So I think we're going to have to look at the facts. This is a fact. We're burning non-LED lighting and you're overcharging us for it because you ran the utility and into a ditch. And you're continuing to run it deeper into the ditch. And thank God for a very sophisticated design where rogue presidents of the United States, rogue local elected officials, there's a system of check and balances to deal with this. Because ultimately, we own the utility. And even though we were foolish enough to elect all of you, there's people in higher places that can indemnify us against our stupidity. Thank you very much for your time.
Next speaker, please. Welcome.
Good afternoon. My name is Nkwanda Ja. I want to thank Commissioner Warren in stepping up to the plate to sound the alarm of the climate emergency. I chaired NAACP and Environmental and Climate Justice Committee. We are 20 organizations strong. Our youngest is 15. Our oldest, upward of me. We meet monthly to discuss ways we as an organization can educate each other and then our wider community through community forums and participation in local events. Most of you, I think, attended our intergenerational community discussion on the climate crisis this summer. More than 200 people came together to talk about the climate crisis in the middle of the day on a weekday. At this month's meeting a couple of days ago, we had 18 people in attendance, and by a show of hands, a majority felt it was more than appropriate for you to declare climate crisis emergency. We need you, our leaders, as city commissioners, to plan for the citizens you represent. We all know that it's always our most vulnerable citizens who suffer the greatest in a crisis. The NAACP wants to make sure in this community we recognize this does happen, and that we will work to ensure that our most vulnerable are included in the climate crisis planning in Gainesville and Alachua County. Dealing with this emergency now gives us an opportunity as we are preparing to make sure we prepare for all. Our Environmental and Climate Justice Committee will be submitting a document to you within the next 60 days with guiding principles around safe water, food, housing, and energy. We hope that you will incorporate our principles into your comp plan and all other documents you use to guide your staff. Thank you.
Thank you. Next speaker, please.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor, members of the commission. My name is Bob Tancic. I work with a couple of groups here in town, Climate Reality Project, who are actually right now in the middle of our 24 hours of reality. We're making presentations all over the community today to bring awareness of the climate emergency. So this is a very timely motion. I also work with Citizens Climate Lobby. I think in that capacity, I think I've spoken to all of you about a bill that we've been promoting, a policy actually that has only now more recently become a bill in Congress, H.R. 763, the Energy Innovation and Carbon Dividend Act. It would be great to get a resolution from the City Commission and supporting that bill and encouraging Representative Yoho, whose vote we need in Congress to try to pass that bill. But we also are happy to report that across the street, the County Commission very recently adopted a resolution to establish a climate advisory committee and will be now applying the criteria of impacts on climate to government decisions, county government decisions. So I certainly encourage the support. We appreciate, of course, the adoption of that goal of 100% renewable energy by 2045. Climate Reality Project is also running a campaign of trying to get our county to sign on to 100% renewable energy by 2030, and it would encourage the city to maybe sign on to that goal as well. It's a little more ambitious, perhaps. It's less comprehensive in that it doesn't include all the other forms of energy, but as far as trying to get city operations as 100% renewable electricity by 2030. So again, I've been working on this issue for many years. We've lost a lot of time, a lot of water under the bridge, and business as usual, as my colleagues here have mentioned, is not going to get the job done. At one of the earliest conferences I went to for Citizens Climate Lobby in Washington, we had Dr. Jim Hansen, a world-renowned climate scientist, talk about the issue for us. And the takeaway I had from that is he said that we do have an opportunity to act. The window of opportunity is still open, but that it's closing. And so, indeed, we are in an emergency, and we need to start acting ambitiously. And the word there, of course, is act. The proclamation is great. But I do encourage, again, follow-up and actually concrete steps to address the problem. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Would anybody else like to speak on the motion?
Hi, good afternoon, and thank you, Mr. Mayor and commissioners. My name is Hannah Bunkin, and I grew up here in Gainesville. and I've recently moved back after finishing my graduate degree that centered on climate governance. I wanted to voice my strong and unwavering support for the city to declare a climate emergency. Let there be no mistake, this is an emergency, and when it will be an emergency for the rest of my life and my children's lives and their children's lives. I turned 25 at the end of the hottest month ever recorded in our Earth's history, and I am one of the lucky ones. The homeless, the workers who live paycheck to paycheck, women and children, undocumented immigrants, those who depend upon the land for sustenance. We must focus on those who have contributed the least to the climate crisis and who will suffer the most from the ongoing warfare being waged on ecological systems and human beings. This requires empathy, and it requires knowledge of the science of climate change and ecology. It also requires admitting when we don't know something and being willing to seek outside guidance. When we empathize with those who lived through Hurricane Irma in the Bahamas this summer, and with those who were washed out to sea, we can begin to recognize the urgency of reducing our local emissions and the need to strengthen our local community so that when we are hit with a storm of that magnitude, we will know that we did everything we could to protect our most vulnerable. This is a disaster. Let there be no mistake. Climate change is a multiplier. The ecological devastation and pollution of our air, water, and soil, fueled by the Industrial Revolution, is compounded by the accumulation of greenhouse gases in our atmosphere. The carbon-intensive industrial-scale farming that has depleted our soils of nutrients and poisoned our watersheds will be further impacted by heat waves, droughts, and floods. We need a just transition for farmers. We need a just transition for workers whose industries can no longer exist in a zero-emissions future, which, by the way, in accordance with the very best climate science, can be no later than 2030. We need our children to understand what they are facing, and we must create the social institutions that they can depend upon in an uncertain future. Every decision that the city and county makes from here on out can and should be situated within our goal of rapidly mitigating and adapting to climate change. I'm so grateful already for the city's commitment to reaching renewable energy targets, and I'm hopeful that you will continue to expand the reach of those of these climate considerations for my generation and the generations to come. Thank you.
Thank you. Would anybody else like to speak on the motion? Okay, we'll close public comment and turn back to the commission. Commissioner Areola.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and I also want to thank the commissioner for bringing this forward, as well as our residents for coming to support this measure. It is without a doubt the challenge for our way of life to save the planet and to do so without delay. I have been going to many of these different workshops and forums and meetings, and what I'm always encouraged by is the fact that there are young faces, there are old faces, there are everyone from every walk of life is beginning to realize the severity of this problem. What I would say just for our residents is later we'll be taking up a resolution to decide whether we will become the first city in Florida to support the Green New Deal, which is the federal program that has been offered by members of Congress. It's going to take international and national leadership to solve this problem, and I hope that we continue to put pressure on our representatives to recognize that fact. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you again, Commissioner, for bringing this forward, and thank you for everyone who's been working on this and that brought it to us for action. We look forward to getting down to the actual policy work that this requires, and that's going to take a lot of work through our comp plan process. I imagine that we will need to get this on a general policy committee meeting, probably in conjunction with the Green New Deal, and look more specifically and practically on what we need to do to take the concrete steps to do this. But this is a good start, and I'm very hopeful for where this is going to lead. So thank you very much, Commissioner, for bringing it before us. So with that, all in favor of the motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Thank you very much, and we will be in recess until 5:30.